Now I have a chutzpah kashayla. I hope this is not recorded. Where did the Shulchan Aruch make a mistake? It's not recorded, right? Bishinui. Where did the Shulchan Aruch make a mistake? It's not my shayla, therefore I feel comfortable asking it. It's a Kotzke Rebbe's question. Where did the Shulchan Aruch make a mistake? Mistake. The Kotzke Rebbe, in his very sharp style, once said, the Choshen Mishpat, Shin Nun Tes, the Shulchan Aruch rules la halacha, one is not allowed to steal. Said the Shulchan Aruch, what a mistake. What a mistake. The Shulchan Aruch should have written, it's an Indian, not to steal. Once you say, you're not allowed to, well, that's not exactly what he meant. We have to analyze it. Sometimes you, muta, it's a mitzvah. It's not really so. But once you say, listen, there's an Indian, there's a big Indian, not to steal. But it's an Indian. What's the raya to the Kotzke Rebbe? Said the Kotzke Rebbe, look at Shavuos. There's an Indian to stay up the whole night. Allah hapsuka, and it's not me'akev, and you're yoitze, choyvas, the yontif, if you didn't. There's an Indian, it's a big Indian. Everybody stays up. Lotigzol, when it says don't steal, it's not really what it means. If the Shulchan Aruch would have written, it's a big Indian not to steal, people would stay away. It's a very good thing. It's an Indian not to steal. But when you say don't, people come up, wait a second, it's not so clear. There's a guy in Yeshiva who brings a bottle of milk every day. There with his coffee. A cereal. By 10 o'clock in the morning, the bottle is already finished. Every single day. So one day he took a little sticker and he wrote on it, private. Following day, 9:30 is already gone. Following day he writes, please don't use. For personal use only. The following day, 9:15, bottle is empty. So his friend tells him, listen, it's not going to work. You should write, Chalav Stam. It's not Chalav Yisrael. Nobody touched that milk for 2 weeks. Listen, Chalav Yisrael, it's an Indian, Chalav Stam. Yeah. His friend brought an orange every single day to Yeshiva. Same thing. Orange disappeared. He wrote on it private, disappeared. He wrote on it, please don't use, disappeared. The following day he wrote on it, Heter Mechira. Heter Mechira! What do I say? Don't steal? No, it's an Indian, apparently. It's an Indian. Shulchan Aruch wrote, don't steal! No. In Yerushalmi, in Yevamos, Perek Yud Beis, Halacha Aleph, the Yerushalmi says, Minhag, Oiker Halacha. Sometimes the Minhag has such koyach, as if, uproot a Halacha. What's the raya to that? There's a Halacha Psuka. If one borrows money, he must repay. He must pay back. And yet people don't do that. You see, Minhag, Oiker Halacha, the Minhag is not to pay. So people borrow money, they don't pay. That's a Minhag. You see the Minhag, Oiker Halacha. Oivei. We said we're talking in the realm of Musa. When it says, don't steal, the Shulchan Aruch actually means it. The Torah meant it. Nafka Mina, Lemaise. People work in their office, and they pick up the phone belonging to their work, and they use it for private use. It's either 12 cents, maybe less. Sometimes it's not even bichlal in today's world where you pay a set amount for the whole month. But you're stealing the time of your work. You're supposed to be working at that time. But it was only 30 seconds. I'm coming up at 4. That's called stealing. People print Divrei Torah just to have something to say on the Shabbos table. But if you're doing it using somebody else's printer, ink, paper, it belongs to your boss, not to you. You have to ask permission. Minag Medina, we said before, Minag Oikir Halacha. That's not true. You have to ask. And if you get permission and the boss says you can do it, you can. He doesn't say you can. You cannot. B'meh Dvorim Amorim, listen to an unbelievable Maaseh. Harav Kook, Zichrono Levracha, was once, he needed to do a get. Two Eidim came. Everything was ready. 1 o'clock, they sit down, and one of the Eidim took out from his bag a blank paper, and he wanted to write something for himself, a note. And Rav Kook noticed that on the top, it said, Bank of Palestine. This guy was a worker for the Bank of Palestine, and apparently, he just took something belonging to the bank, and he's writing a personal
note for himself.
Choshen Mishpat Simin Lamed Dalet, we learn that a person who's a gazlan is pasul leidus. What do you do? It's probably less than Shveputa. Maybe back then it wasn't. I don't know. Rav Kook says, let's daven mincha. Before they get, let's daven mincha. Fine. They got eight other guys, and Rav Kook stands up. It's now 1:10 p.m., and he starts davening. And he's davening. And he's davening. He davened until 7:30 p.m. At night, you don't write a get. The following day, they already got a better ed. Because he assumed this guy's a Rasha, he can't be part of the get, he didn't want to embarrass him, so he found a very clever way to do it. Even though it's half a puta, if it doesn't belong to you, so even though the Shulchan Aruch made a mistake, the Shulchan Aruch did not make any mistake. The Shulchan Aruch knew what the Torah meant. Lo tigzol means just that. Lo tignov ve lo tigzol, that means don't take something which doesn't belong to you. There was once a very sophisticated thief. And he came and he said, you can actually steal from a kal v'chomer. I have a kal v'chomer that will allow you to steal. And what if, uma'im, to my own pocket, to my own wallet, you are not allowed to go in, but I am allowed to. That means it's a very strict type of a wallet, right? You're not allowed. You don't have any permission to come into my pocket, but I do. Your pocket, that you are allowed to go in, how much more so that I'll be allowed to? Kal v'chomer. Mine is very chamur, it's very strict because you're not allowed to go in, only I'm allowed to. But to you, to yours, that you are allowed to, apparently it's very kal. And therefore, how much more so that I'll be allowed to go into your pocket? Does this kal v'chomer work? No. Why not? Break it. Oh. So first of all, even if it did work, doesn't make a difference. The Torah said, don't steal! So it's not going to help you to come with all the people pulling in the world. The Torah says no, so no. And the kal v'chomer doesn't work because how does it start? And what if to your pocket, to my pocket, that you're not allowed to come in? Wait a second. Based on your kal v'chomer, he's also allowed to come into your pocket because just like you are able to go into his pocket, he's allowed to go into your pocket, so the kal v'chomer doesn't even start.